I don't think I'm gonna vote because I'm not informed on anything. I haven't done any research, so I feel like my vote's gonna be wasted.
I feel like being young and voting, people will judge you for it because you're not educated enough about the whole voting process.
I don't think my vote matters. I think the whole thing is predetermined. The idea of voting is kind of like a scheme.
Most of my friends aren't gonna vote because they have the same opinion as me. They don't really see politics as something that's important to them.
I am Antonio Valdovinos de la Mora. I was born in Colima, Mexico, and we immigrated when I was 2 years old. We grew up with very little. I felt that I could become a man by joining the Marines. When I was 18, the Marine recruiter came by, and at some point he's like, "So, are you a US citizen?" And I was like, "No." Then he goes, "Get out of the vehicle. You're wasting my time." It was shattering to me to be told to leave because I was from Mexico. Like, holy shit, like, I don't think I'm gonna be able to do anything in my life.
Who's not voting is folks that have been disengaged for so long. We want to make sure that everybody knows who's running, why they're running, and why we're talking to them.
Lo queríamos visitar hoy, otra vez, como siempre le venimos cada año para hablar de quién está corriendo y quién lo representa.
In 2011, the precincts we were walking had 300 votes participating, and the northern precincts, the ones that had the clean park, the brand new asphalt, had almost over 3,000 participating voters. And so it was clear that if our folks weren't voting, we were not getting any resources from the city of Phoenix. We just kept knocking on doors, and by the end of that year, we took the victory. We elected the first Latino for city council in a 67% Latino district. And so it became a big story, and when Time Magazine picked it up, and they're like, how did Phoenix just elect the first Latino? I remember holding the magazine and thinking, "Mom, look, we made it on Time Magazine." Knocking on doors, talking to Latinos about participating. Every year we have to come out here and talk to our community to make sure that they're as informed as possible.
All right, guys, welcome, 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 and thank you so much for coming. Our city is in better shape, and it's literally because of every single one of you, right? Every single door that you talk to, every time that you use your Spanish to help somebody understand why it's critical for them to participate.
My peers, they don't think their voices count, and so my job is to explain to them that their vote does matter.
It's really fabulous.
I've had firsthand experience with politics affecting my life, like the deportation of my father. That is one reason I stepped forward to be able to make sure that people are voting for the right people.
All of the 18-year-olds that are graduating high school spend zero amount of time being educated on the importance of voting. We're really, really working hard to help people understand the bridge between voting and representation.